today's look at the leaders of the game. This week on Coaches, Calgary Flames assistant coach Brad McCrimmon. McCrimmon has been an assistant in Calgary for two seasons. From 1998 to 2000, Brad was head coach of the WHL's Saskatoon Blades. Prior to that, he spent one season as an assistant coach for the New York Islanders. McCrimmon played for Boston, Philadelphia, Calgary, Detroit, Hartford, and Phoenix during his Hard Rock 18-year NHL career. Brad McCrimmon grew up wanting to be a hockey coach.
I think it's just one of those things that, from my background, that hockey is was our topic. Hockey and farming, that's all we talked about. So we're kind of like the Hunter brothers, I guess, in a lot of ways. And the Sutter brothers, that was our topics at the dinner table, or sitting on the tractor, or hauling hay, and it just progressed to this.
Up there with Patterson and Mullen. Gilmore behind the net, looks around, into the middle, they score! Brad McCrimmon! Game is tied, 4-4.
Our dinner table talked farming and hockey every day, didn't matter what day of the year it was. So I guess maybe it got planted then, but through the course of the playing career, and as you get into your 30s, and you start taking on different roles on teams, and one of those is tutor roles, and I had different guys that I sort of tutored on breaking into the league and defense and stuff, and that sort of progresses into the idea when you get done playing, you have to stay in the game, and coaching is certainly a great element. You're not on the ice, but you can smell it, as I always say, and it's a good thing. I did enjoy playing for, I have to confess, I enjoyed playing for Mike Keenan. People think I'm nuts, but it was good. It was a real black and white situation. You knew what you had to do, and it was real easy. You try and learn and take things from each individual, and then try and combine it with some of your own thoughts. And I'll be lucky. I've had a lot of good people there. I call it beg, borrow, and steal. You get a lot of ideas from different people, and you do that all the time. I don't think it gets to what would he do or what would this guy do at a particular point. You just take the information you've gathered from different people and your own experiences. You play 18 years, you get different experiences for sure, so you just try and go off of that. And a lot of times it's what your gut tells you, and that's that's what this business is about sometimes, is what your gut tells you in a certain situation. I haven't got the experience base of Brian Murray and Tom Watt, both who I played for. They're great guys, and their experience base dwarfs what I've been through. But you have a lot of things from a pro standpoint, and seeing people improve and taking ideas that the staff throws out and trying them. They go, hey, that works. That's good. So that's fun. And then as a coach, I have the expression, like I said earlier, you're not on the ice, but you can smell it. So you're as close to the competition as you're going to be. And the hockey coaching is right. You're right down there. You can see the sweat popping off of people, and they get hit. And to me, it's exciting, and that's a rush. I mean, being close to the game at that level is still exciting and enjoyable. And the fact that you can't play is the next best thing. Well, my last year in Phoenix, I was hurt the last half of the year, and I trained the whole summer as to prepare to play, and then just didn't work out. So through the course of summer, it wasn't looking like I was going to get a playing job, and I wanted to coach. So I was very fortunate. I got hooked up with Rick Bonus and Wayne Fleming on the island, and I don't know if anybody knows those two, but they're great people. And I couldn't have landed a better spot for my first year out. Your first year out is a little different. You're not playing anymore. You don't have the same release of being on the ice and getting after it. So it's a big adjustment. I don't care what people say, it is a big adjustment. I was fortunate to have those two individuals to guide me through that first year. There is a change, a mindset changes. You don't have the same emotional release as a coach as you did as a player. The game's not going good or whatever, you can go there and have some fun and do your business. But as a coach, you gotta relax and stay back there and keep yourself under control, and you don't have the same emotional outlet. So that's the biggest change, I think, from being a player to a coach. But the transition, I didn't consider it a tough thing at all.
We'll be right back on Coaches with the Flames assistant, Brad McCrimmon.